So it is Wednesday, December 4th, and today Disney Plus has officially integrated ESPN Plus into the Disney Plus app. Here's everything you need to know, as well as a first look. So when you first open up the Disney Plus app, at least if your app has refreshed, you will now see seven different tiles on the home screen. There were originally five, then they added eventually the tile for Hulu, and now there is a tile for ESPN. Now, what is included on this ESPN tile when you click this? So if you are a standalone Disney Plus subscriber, there are going to be a handful of sports that you can watch with your subscription, even if you are not subscribed to the bundle. However, if you are subscribed to the Disney Bundle Trio, so the one that includes Disney Plus, Hulu, and ESPN Plus, it will include the sports from ESPN Plus integrated together into the same app, in the same way that they have integrated Hulu into the Disney Plus app. So with this, I definitely feel like Disney is going for making Disney Plus into the spot for all of their streaming entertainment. The one holdout at this point is Hulu Plus Live TV, but you know, will that come down the road in the future? We'll see. But for now, at least you can watch these different shows that they've got here. You can watch live sports from ESPN Plus, and you can watch all of that good stuff that you'd normally find on ESPN Plus. You can now find on the Disney Plus app, at least if you are subscribed to the Disney Bundle Trio. Now let's get into the specifics of what's included if you're subscribed to Disney Plus, but not the Disney Bundle Trio. So in the press release from Disney, they said that standalone Disney Plus subscribers will have access to a curated selection of live sports events, studio shows, and ESPN films from ESPN Plus, as well as a select collection of TV series and films from Hulu. Interestingly enough, that's a new thing. From ESPN Plus, this includes some exciting and unique events in the coming weeks, such as The Simpsons Fun Day Football, animated Monday Night Football game, a Christmas Day lineup of five NBA games, plus the Dunk the Halls animated NBA presentation, select 30 for 30 documentaries, and day one coverage from the Australian Open. Now, interestingly enough, they also say that for Hulu, standalone Disney Plus subscribers will be able to enjoy groundbreaking movies and series at launch, including Shogun, Will Trent, Solar Opposites, Reservation Dogs, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and more. So it sounds like both for ESPN Plus and Hulu, they are giving a taste of both of their streaming services, even if you aren't subscribed to either the Disney Bundle Duo or Disney Bundle Trio. Now, you might be familiar, they did just have their Black Friday sale, which is now wrapped up. That Black Friday sale, you could get the Disney Bundle Duo, so Disney Plus and Hulu, for $2.99 a month. It does not include all of ESPN Plus. You want to get ESPN Plus, you would have to go through Hulu and do the add-on, which is $11.99 a month. You can, I believe, at least to the best of my knowledge, you can do that add-on to the $2.99 deal. That will bring your total down to $14.98, which is a bit cheaper than the $16.99 a month it would normally cost to get the Disney Bundle Trio. But just be aware, if you got that $2.99 a month deal, you would still have to pay full price for the ESPN Plus portion if you now want to watch all of those live sports through the Disney Plus app. Now, there is one other rather confusing thing with ESPN Plus, which boggles my mind. It boggles a lot of other people's minds. I don't blame you for being confused by this. And that is that ESPN Plus and ESPN the channel do not have 100% of the same lineup. You can actually make a Venn diagram of like things that are only on ESPN the channel, things that are only on ESPN Plus, the streaming service. And there is, of course, a pretty big overlap in that middle section, but it is not, just one and the same as far as what live sports are on which service. Now, later on in 2025, Disney plans to launch a new sports streaming service. That will be their flagship ESPN streaming service that includes all of the sports that would normally be on ESPN the channel. But this will be in addition to ESPN Plus, which I do think is confusing. But anyway, what do you think about this integration together between Disney Plus and ESPN Plus? let me know your thoughts in the comment section. If you want to stay up to date with Disney Plus and Hulu and ESPN Plus and all of those great streaming services, make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel and also follow another YouTube channel that I highly recommend, and that is What's on Disney Plus from Roger Palmer. I did have him on my podcast before. He's a great guy. I know he's going to be talking about this ESPN Plus integration on his YouTube channel, so definitely make sure to follow his YouTube channel as well. That does it for this video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.